I'm Shadash Rao and welcome to Sada Learning Hub. Today's session we are going to learn Java standard tag library SQL tags in JSP. If you see here in my previous video, I discussed the core tags in the Java JSTL library. Now in this video, I'm going to cover about an SQL tags. What are the different SQL tags are available in the JSTL library? If you see, before going to, I'm giving you some brief introduction about a JSTL tags. If you see, the JSTL tags is introduced by the Sun Microsystem from the version JSP 1.2 onwards. If you use these Java standard tag library tags, those are going to reduce your Java code. Now there is so many tags are available. Those are categorized into five tags, five categories. In these five categories, I'm previous video I'm covered a core tags. Now this video I'm going to cover about an SQL tags. SQL tags. Now there is a different SQL tags are available. I'm going to discuss about most wanted SQL tags in the Java standard tag library. If you see first one, SQL colon set data source. If you see SQL colon set data source, it is used to create a simple data source suitable only for prototyping. Means if you want to connect with the database, definitely we need to pass some parameters to code. For example, if you want to connect a Oracle or if you want to connect a MySQL, definitely we need to pass what is the URL of that particular database, what is the username, what is the password, which database you are going to connect. This information definitely we need to pass. That all type of information we need to pass by using the tag SQL colon set data source. There is different attributes are available for that set data source, like that username, password, URL. All those things, it will be used to create a data source, means it will be used to create a connection with the database inject into your whatever variable you want. It will be injected into that particular variable. The next tag is SQL colon query tag. Means it executes the SQL query defined in its body or through the SQL attributes. Now it is okay, fine. I'm using set data source. I'm open the connection. After that, we need to execute some commands. For that commands, definitely we need to create a SQL colon query tag. Whatever the query you are given in between SQL colon query, it will be automatically executed by using SQL query tag. Next, SQL colon update. Whatever the update operations, if you see SQL colon query, it executes the select operations. It returns the some result set. If you see SQL colon update, it is going to execute the non-select operations. It may be update or it may be a delete or it may be a insert. It will be execute like that statements. Execute the SQL update defined in the body or through the SQL attributes. The fourth one is SQL colon param. It sets the parameters into the SQL statements to the specified values. Excuse me. The SQL param sets a parameters into the in an SQL statements into the specified values. The fifth tag is SQL colon date param. It sets the parameter in an SQL statements to specified java.util.date values. If you want to pass any date values to your query or insert statement something, definitely we need to use, you are passing the different date values are available. All those things we need to put it in a SQL colon date param. Now, the sixth one is SQL colon transactions. It provides a nested database actions elements with a shared connections set up to execute all statements as a one transaction. For example, I'm saying that two tables are available, employee and department. Once I'm inserting in the two tables, that is only the successful transaction. If anyone is going fail, the transaction is going fail. In that situation, we need to use SQL colon transaction. For example, employee is going success and DEPT is going fail, means transaction is going fail. If you didn't put any transaction, it is going to give an inconsistent data into your database. That is the one more problem. That's why SQL colon transactions is comes into the picture. Once the two statements are going success, then only your transaction is going success. If one is going success and another one is going fail, that success query is going to roll back by you, by the servlet container. That is the transaction, SQL colon transaction. Now I can explain you a simple Java code. See here, I'm creating a simple example that is called example on JSTL tags in JSP. It is a sample dynamic web application. I'm created this application into my Eclipse IDE. If you want this project, just go through the description. I am pasted the link at the my GitHub repository link. Just go through that GitHub repository link. It's a public access. Just get the project and do the practice. See here, I'm using the taglib directory. I'm importing whatever the library related to SQL tags. See here, whatever I'm putting at here, we can use it ever. Before colon, if you want to put your own name, just rename it SQL to your own name. And here also we need to change it, whatever the before colon, whatever the name we are given, definitely we need to given at here. That's fine. Now I'm going to explain you whatever I'm explaining in the SQL tags. If you see here, data source, what I'm giving a data source, I'm injecting into the variable DS. Here DS is the data source. After that, I'm giving the driver name. My driver name, I'm going to connect with the MySQL. My driver name is called com.mysql.jdbc.driver. And coming to URL, this is the JDBC colon MySQL colon localhost. This is the URL, and Sada is the database name. This is the username. This is the password. Whatever the connections required, I'm giving all the connection properties into the set database. After that, I'm updating something values by using the query update tag. I'm creating a variable called n. After that, this is my data source object. I'm created at here. This is called an expression language dollar. This is an expression language. If you want a clear about expression language, just refer my previous video. Now I'm creating a SQL command. Just what I'm doing is I'm inserting a one row at here. After that, it returns the sum values. How many rows are inserted? It will gives the value. Just I'm giving these many one row is inserted at here. Next, I'm creating SQL colon query. It gives the result set. It gives some results. I'm injecting that results into the variable called RS. I'm giving the data source. After that, I'm giving select star from DEPT table. Whatever the rows are available in the department table, it will be injected into the RS variable. This is the RS is the variable. After that, if you see it here, I'm using core tags into here. If you want core tags, just refer my previous video. These are the core tag for each. For each is the core tag. I'm iterating at here rs.rows. This is the method. Rows means whatever the rows are available into the result set, it will be send it into the k variable. Now, each and every row, it is sent into the k variable. K is an object of department. If you see, k is an object of the department. I am retrieving the values from the department. This is the column name. I will show you. I am created into my database. This is my database. I am entering the password. Use. Whatever the database use, I'm connecting to MySQL database. Now, select star from DAPT. See, these many rows are available. Whenever I'm executing, it will be inserted into the, this one is the new row, it will be inserted into the database and it will be retrieve all the rows and will be displayed into the browser. Now if you see into my lib folder, there is a dependencies are available. These are all JSTL related jars. This is the servlet related jar and this is the servlet related jar. All these jars are available at here. Now I'm going to execute this one and next one is this project is available into my GitHub repository, public GitHub repository. If you want, just go through link I'm pasted into the description. Just go through the link and get the project. Now JSTL SQL .jsp. See here, if you see here, what I am doing is I am inserting one row. If you see, I am inserting one row. What it is saying, one row is inserted. After that, one row is inserted. After that, what I am doing is I am iterating for each loop. Whatever I am result is getting, I'm iterating for each loop, I'm getting result at here. If you see, all these results are available. If you see, this is the already two records are available in the database. Now, before execution, this is, if you see, these are the two only is available. Now, whenever I'm executing, one more row is inserted. This is the two, one more row inserted plus three, it will be displayed at the here. This is the way the Java code is reduced into your JSP page. This is about a SQL.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel SAD.Learning Hub because we have many session that would help you to develop our skills and I will be back soon. Till then you take care. Bye bye.